Welcome to Chemistry with Caroline. In this video, we're going to look at an introduction to carbon-13 NMR. So carbon-13 NMR can be a handy tool in putting together the pieces of a puzzle to solve a structure for an organic molecule. About 1% of carbon is carbon-13. It's NMR active due to its odd mass number. So what that means is it can couple to protons that are on it and also protons that are next door to it. What that leads to is a very complex spectrum. Organic molecules are comprised predominantly of carbons and hydrogens. You'd have different coupling constants for those that were on, directly attached to the carbon, and those that were next door neighbors to the atom. So as a result, that spectrum is usually too complex for us to interpret. So what we do is we run a proton decoupled spectrum when we're doing carbon-13 analysis. And so what we see in the carbon-13 is no splitting. We see each unique carbon having one signal associated with it, but that signal is always going to be a singlet. The method that we use to run that spectrum, the decoupled method, also distorts the peak intensities. So as a result, we don't integrate our peaks. So we see no splitting and no integration in the carbon-13 NMR. It's possible that two carbon-13s could couple, but given the low natural abundance, the chances of them being next door is really small, and so you really just see singlets in the carbon-13 NMR. So let's go to the next slide, and we'll take a look at what information we can get out of this spectrum. So one of the pieces of information that I do get out of a carbon-13 NMR is the number of unique carbons in that molecule. And that is going to equal the number of signals that is observed. So this is the same thing we see in a proton NMR. If we have five unique types of protons, we see five signals. If we had five unique carbons, we'd see five signals in the carbon-13 NMR. We only see signals for carbons. Doesn't matter if there's protons on them or not. We're just looking at carbons in the carbon-13 NMR. The other piece of information we get is the type of carbon or the type of neighbor. And that is from the chemical shift. So where the signal shows up on the spectrum. The chemical shift range for carbon-13 is quite a bit bigger, 0 to 200 ppm, as opposed to 0 to about 12 for proton NMR. But the principles regarding chemical shift are the same. So we'll have another in-depth video on chemical shift and an additional one on the number of signals to expect. But this has been an introduction to carbon-13 NMR. What information we can expect to gain from that. If you found this video helpful, please like, subscribe, and share with your friends. Thanks.